Hello guys, Salty Gamer here, and today I'll be reviewing Isekai Cheat Magician. I knew people were getting tired of the Isekai anime genre, but I didn't think it would get this bad. This anime got a score of 5.38 on my anime list. That is unheard of. I've never seen an Isekai anime series with that low of a score. Even the Isekai anime series Arifureta got a score of 6.52, and so many people were complaining about how awful it was. So if Arifureta is awful, what does that make this anime? Trash? I didn't even want to watch this anime series because I hate seeing childhood friends as love interest in anime. But considering so many people watch this anime and hate it, I just had to see what made it so bad. The premise isn't that unique. You heard it many times before. The main character Taichi and his childhood friend Rin have been summoned from a different world with the goal of protecting the kingdom from those that threaten it. Taichi and Rin quickly learn magic and become overpowered. They are now taking quests as adventurers, and also have to protect the kingdom in the meantime. Even though there's a lot of hate against the Isekai anime series right now, I believe they should be given a fair chance because perhaps there'll be one that's unique, like ReZero. Well, this isn't one of them. Nothing about Isekai Cheat Magician stands out. Taichi and Rin just take part in quests, and have to protect the kingdom from characters that want to cause chaos. How is that unique in any way? We've seen that many times before in Isekai anime series that involve adventurers. At least we don't see a cliche demon king in this, but still, there's nothing about this Isekai anime series that is really good and separates itself from other Isekai anime series. I mean, the characters just use typical elemental spells and typical weapons like swords to attack. I'm not impressed by his spells. There isn't much strategy to the fights. The main character gets saved on multiple occasions by a sudden power-up. In other words, plot armor. There were two things that were supposed to make this Isekai anime series unique. First is that summoning magic is different from typical elemental magic. They aren't the same thing, but like, who really cares? Magic is still magic after all. That doesn't make the magic in this anime series seem interesting to me. So what if the summoning magic in this anime series is a little different than summoning magic in other anime series? It isn't anything that amazing. The most important thing that was supposed to make this anime so unique is that it included a second overpowered character in the childhood friend Rin. We always see the protagonist in the Isekai anime series be the most powerful character by far, and stand in the spotlight alone. Other characters aren't even close to their power. In this anime though, Rin was supposed to be as powerful as Taichi. So maybe, this time, we won't have to see one character do everything. The problem is Taichi quickly surpasses Rin in power. Rin even becomes a damsel in distress at one point. And in the final battle, in the most important battle, it's up to Taichi to save everyone. Like, why even include a childhood friend in the show? You built her up so much in the beginning of the series, but by the end, Taichi is the one that must defeat the main villain alone. How is that different from other Isekai anime series, where the main character is most powerful and must do everything by themselves in order to protect everyone? Just having this childhood friend ruin the romance in the show for me. You just know that the other girls in the show won't even have a chance with Taichi, and he'll end up with this boring childhood friend. There wasn't even good romantic development between Rin and Taichi in this season. I did not like the main characters in the show. They were as boring as you can get. Taichi is a generic nice guy that must protect everyone. How generic and boring. He's not funny, he's not cool. There is nothing about his personality that is unique. Rin is a typical childhood friend. She cares about Taichi and wants to protect him. She gets embarrassed when he sees her without clothes. She's just like every other childhood friend. I just find his character is lacking in personality. She isn't a seductive character like Momo from To Love Ru. She isn't loving like Rem from ReZero. She isn't creepy like Yuno from Future Diary. She isn't anything. The opening song for this anime series is one of the best opening songs of all time. This song is simply amazing. It's so catchy. It's the one good thing about this anime series. The ending song was okay. The music throughout the anime was alright. It wasn't anything special. The animation style looked okay. It didn't really stand out. The animation looked alright as well. I didn't see any choppy animation. It looked smooth for the most part. I would recommend to skip this anime series. It adds nothing to the Isekai anime genre. The only good thing about it is the opening song. I give this anime a 5 out of 10. As boring as it was though, it did make me rage, so I'd still say it's better than Isekai anime series The Master of Ragnarok and Blesser of Enherjar. So no, it isn't the worst Isekai anime series of all time, it's the second worst. So that's all I'm gonna talk about for today, thank you for watching the video, have a great day night whoever you are, and please like and subscribe if you enjoy this video, and please comment if you found anything interesting in the video.